Hi there, my name is Dan, and this is a free clip from my larger Microsoft Word training course. Check out the link in the description or go to bringyourownlaptop.com for more. Hi, in this video, we're going to look at downloading and installing a new font to use. Okay, it's just going to be this guy at the top here we're using for our brand heading. Okay, so let's go and look at where we can download them and how to install them. So first up, where can we get fonts? Now you can pay for fonts. Okay, the best place if you want to buy a font, okay, is some place called My Fonts. Now if you've got a font you need, your client uses it, or you need to buy another license, this is where you go for paid fonts. Okay, it's called myfonts.com. There's lots of places you can buy fonts from, but this is probably the best and the most common, at least. What I really like about this site is that if you are looking for a new font, okay, they have really good, like, sometimes you look at a font, you're like, oh, is that any good? But it's not until, say this font here, I'm not too sure about it, it's not until you actually see it laid up before you're like, actually, that is a really cool font. Okay, so I love that site for this type of thing. You might see, like, there's the font there, used as part of other fonts, as part of imagery. It's really quite cool. All right, so My Fonts is where you go to buy them. Let's say you've got no budget, and like everyone does, and you've got to get some free fonts. So there's a couple of places. 1001 Free Fonts is one of them. Da Font is another. Those are probably the most common, the ones that I like the least, mainly because there's lots of junk there. There's just lots of stuff you're never going to use. There's fonts shaped like cactuses, or there's all sorts of random stuff. So I like to jump to one of these two. Okay, Font Squirrel is a really nice one. It's nicely curated. There's no junk there. They also have nice explanations, like showing you versions of it, okay, before you download it. And probably the hidden gem of buying fonts, okay, or getting free fonts is Google. Okay, so fonts.google.com is a really good site for getting fonts, and I'll show you how we'll use this one. The technique is the same for lots of them. So what you can do is, say you are looking for a font and it's for the Bring Your Own Laptop, okay, you can go into here and just start typing. Watch this, I can say, actually, I want to know what this one actually looks like. So bring your, so you can see it before you actually download it. Sometimes you see a font and it looks cool in the little explanation, but when you type in your details, okay, it might look naff. I don't like that font. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to go through and pick a font. I've already had a little look through, and up here in the right on search, I'm going to use Scope. Okay, and I like this one here, Scope 1, and I'm going to click on it. And you can decide, you can see different things, okay, but eventually what you want to do is go to this one that says Select Font. Okay, you can either do it in here, or you can go back and you can click this little plus button in the corner there, and it adds it to this little group down here. So it's added to this little group, and it's meant to be used for web stuff, but the cool thing about Google Fonts is you can download them to your system and use them for all sorts of things. Okay, you want to click this little arrow here, click on him. It's going to download a folder. Okay, I'm going to put this in your exercise files. I'll put it into O2 newsletter, and I'll stick it in here for you so you don't have to download it if you want to use it. Okay, sometimes if you're working at a company, sometimes they don't like you downloading stuff. Okay, and what happens is it comes down in this little zip file. I'm going to double click it to open it. And there he is there. Okay, Scope 1, regular. I'm going to double click him. Okay, and we're going to click install. I'm going to edit. Cool, and that is installed. Now, if you've downloaded it from Font Squirrel or 1001 Free Fonts, they're the same. You'll get a zip file, you open it up, you'll double click them to install them. This font only has one weight, okay? This one here, regular, but you might have a bold italic, so you might have to install a few different ones, okay, rather than just the one like we did. I'm gonna close this down, and hopefully now, if I jump back into my Word document, I can go up to here to my heading here, and I can decide you now are going to be, I'm at home, jump this down, okay, and what I might have to do is just type it in here, just Scope 1, there he is, nice, and I'm going to increase the file size for my heading, how big, yeah, something like that. Great, so that is how to download and install a new font, okay, from any of the online options, and yeah, start using it in your Word document. All right, before we go, I'm just going to kind of tidy up the fonts. I want to use this, I would like to use my color that we installed earlier, okay, my green. There he is there, click on him. I'm gonna make this a little bigger. Cool shortcut for making fonts bigger. Obviously you can use this and that's pretty cool. Okay, but if you have it selected, okay, you can use Control Shift to hold both of those down on your keyboard and hit the full stop key. Okay, and the comma key makes it smaller. So often that's quite a quick, easy way to go and do it. So in terms of my body copy font, I'm gonna leave it as Calibri. Okay, and actually what I wanna do is I'm gonna switch it to Arial, just cause a lot of people have their corporate fonts as Arial. I don't not like it, just a bit plain. Okay, so that's gonna be my fonts that I'm gonna use in here, and I might use the bold version along the top. Okay, so for my newsletter, and for my actual body copy here, what I'm going to do is font sizes, okay, if you are looking at a magazine, any magazine, pretty much the, like 99% of them are set to 10 points, okay? That is a, like, it's the majority of the world can read it, okay? It's a really common body copy size. Word, earlier versions of Word set default to 12, the newer version says to 11. I think they're still too big. Really depends on your client. If you're dealing with the elderly or the visually impaired, you're gonna have a font size, maybe 12 is a better size for you, but 10 is works for me. Actually, oh, I don't know, yeah, 10. 10 works for me. Print it off, check. It looks a little small on screen here, but print it off and check it just to get an idea, because you might be, yeah, might be looking okay. The other thing is that this text here, you can see it's just mixed up Latin. It's not broken, it's just placeholder text because we're designing more of a template here, not actual content. Unfortunately, the dynamic spelling checker is going crazy with red lines everywhere. So what we're gonna do is just disable that because it looks ugly for me. To remove it, jump up to File, go down to Options, and then under Proofing, there's this one here, it says check spelling as you type. Okay, and it just gets rid of the right wavy lines. We can do a spell check at the end, we can turn it on in the end once we've got our copy in there, but now it looks pretty. Okay, so that's it for this tutorial. Next video, we're gonna look at setting this stuff as the default. That would be awesome, right? Let's go do that now. How'd you find that video? Was it good? Was it bad? If you liked it, go check out more of my courses on bringyourownlaptop.com.